सो दिस इज़ फोर्थ एप्लीकेशन ऑफ गॉस लॉ टू फाइंड इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ड्यू टू अ यूनिफॉर्मली चार्ज्ड स्फेरिकल शेल और स्फीयर यू कैन से. सो फर्स्ट केस इज व्हेन द पॉइंट इज लाइंग आउटसाइड द शेल और स्फीयर. फॉर पॉइंट्स इफ द पॉइंट लाइज आउटसाइड, आउटसाइड मीन्स डिस्टेंस ऑफ द पॉइंट इज ग्रेटर देन द रेडियस ऑफ द शेल. सो कम टू दिस, हियर यू कैन सी दिस ब्लू सर्कल, दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग योर स्फीयर, गिवन स्फीयर ऑन विच चार्ज क्यू इज बींग यूनिफॉर्मली स्प्रेड. सो ब्लू इज योर गिवन स्फीयर, सो यू कैन राइट कैपिटल आर, कैपिटल आर इज इट्स रेडियस, सो इट इज रेडियस ऑफ गिवन स्फीयर. नाउ यू कैन सी दिस येलो सर्कल, दिस इज गॉशियन स्फीयर, सो दिस इज इमेजिनरी गॉशियन स्फीयर, सो दैट वी कैन यूज गॉस लॉ. So its radius is x. You can see its radius is x. So you'll have to write that too. What is x? X is radius of Gaussian sphere. There are two sphere. One is given sphere whose radius is r, and one is Gaussian sphere whose radius is x. X. And what is the condition right now? First condition is x is greater than r. It means the point is lying outside. So exactly, my yellow circle is lying outside blue circle sphere though. Now come to this. You can see this is your small surface area element ds. Okay, now from positive charges, field is always outward. So this is your electric field and this is your normal. So normal and field angle is 0 degree. Just keep this information ready. Now using Gauss law, we can write this equation. E vector dot ds vector is equal to q by epsilon naught. Open it. A, B, cos theta. Theta I have shown you just 0 degree. Theta is 0 degree. Cos is 1. So it's EDS. EDS is written equal to Q by epsilon naught. Now E outside, DS here, DS integration is S. So it is ES is equal to Q by epsilon naught. S will go down. So E is equal to this. Now S, what is S? S is surface area of Gaussian sphere. Gaussian sphere means, now sphere's surface area is 4 pi radius square and radius of Gaussian sphere is X. So it is S is equal to 4 pi X square. We will substitute here and we'll get electric field outside. So we are ready with the result. Now point is lying inside the Gaussian sphere. So this time your yellow circle, which is representing Gaussian sphere, will be inside. And your radius of Gaussian sphere will be less than the radius of given sphere. Okay. So now you can see where is charge sprinkled. Charge is sprinkled uniformly on given sphere. Okay, but your Gaussian sphere is inside. So no charge is enclosed by Gaussian sphere. So see, I have written no charge is enclosed by Gaussian sphere, Gaussian surface. So Q net is 0. So that means E inside is 0. So that's all. E inside is 0. Two cases are done. Now third case, when the point lies on the sphere, it means X is approximately equal to R. In that situation, you can see this red one is your given sphere. You have to be very clear. Given sphere. And your green one is your Gaussian sphere. Okay, they have to be very close, but Gaussian surface should be a little bit outside. Again, you have to show small ds and electric field and normal and theta is 0. So using Gauss law, again, E dot ds is equal to q by epsilon naught. Open at E ds cos theta, theta is 0. So again, E ds integration is S. S is, what is S? S is surface area of Gaussian sphere. Gaussian sphere. So it will be 4 pi x square, but x is equal to r. We have seen in this case. So x is equal to r. Substitute, you are ready with the electric field. Electric field on the surface of the sphere. So we are ready with three results. One is electric field outside for which x is greater than r. This is the result. It is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught by x square and q is at the numerator. E inside is 0. Electric field inside is 0. Electric field at the surface is this. What is the difference between E outside and E at the surface? Here X is there and here R is there on the surface. Now we have the graph, which is most important. First you should do the labeling of the graph. This is electric field and this is distance X. Then do labeling more. This is X is less than R. It means it is inside. This is X is greater than R. So it means it is outside. And at one point X is equal to R. Now we have to see, inside electric field is 0, so this is, these are the points, this yellow line is the, are the points I have joined, and at R it is this, And how much is the value? E at the surface, you know it, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. Okay, and outside it is, outside formula you can write once again, E is equal to kq. kq means 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q. So if you don't wish to write 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, you can go for kq by x square. Outside it is inversely proportional to distance square. So graph is outside like this. And if you wish, you can join these. You can join this by dotted line. So this is the graph which is very important, E versus distance, for this topic, for spherical.